peace and blessings to each and every one of you. What an honor to begin the Holy Week journey together on this Palm to Passion Sunday. And we certainly include our friends far and near joining us later in the week through the magic of technology. Our liturgy continues. We are on page 2 of the worship leaflet. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, in your tender love for the human race, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to take upon him our nature and to suffer death upon the cross, giving us the example of his great humility. Mercifully grant that we may walk in the way of his suffering and also share in his resurrection through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Christ Jesus is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. My eye is consumed with sorrow, and also my throat and my belly. For my life is wasted with grief, and my years with sighing. My strength fails me because of affliction, and my bones are consumed. I have become a reproach to all my enemies, and even to my neighbors, a dismay to all of my acquaintance. When they see me in the street, they avoid me. I am forgotten like a dead man out of mind. I am as useless as a broken pot. For I have heard the whispering of the crowd. Fear is all around. They put their heads together against me. They plot to take my life. But as for me, I have trusted in you, O Lord. I have said you are my God. My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me. Make your face to shine upon your servant, and in your loving kindness save me.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, Christ.
Jesus went on ahead, going up to Jerusalem. When he had come near Bethphage and Bethany, at the place called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of the disciples, saying, "Go into the village ahead of you, and as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. Untie it and bring it here. And if anyone asks you, why are you untying it? Just say this, the Lord needs it. So those who were sent departed and found it as he had told them. As they were untying the colt, its owner answered him, asked them, why are you untying the colt? They said, the Lord needs it. Then they brought it to Jesus, and after throwing their cloaks on the colt, they set Jesus on it. As he rode along, people kept spreading their cloaks on the road. And as he was now approaching the path down from the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to praise God joyfully with a loud voice for all the deeds of power that they had seen, saying, blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord, peace in heaven and glory in the highest heaven. Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to him, teacher, order your disciples to stop. He answered, I tell you, if these were silent, the stones would shout out. The gospel of the Lord. Return to your stronghold, O prisoners of hope. See. Return to your stronghold, O prisoners of hope. What, to me at least, an enchanting biblical phrase, prisoners of hope. It doesn't come from this gospel reading we just heard, at least not literally, or even from the epistle from the Philippians, but from the very first reading of this scripture-packed day, the Old Testament prophet Zechariah read downstairs, and it's in everyone's bulletin, during the blessing of the palms. Clearly, the gospel writers were familiar with this passage. The immediate circumstances of the prophet, Zechariah, were about 500 years before the time of Jesus, right after the Babylonian exile, when people were coming back to rebuild Jerusalem. They were looking to be a strong, independent nation, not a broken vassal state, to be led by their own king, not an occupying force. Into this time of dislocation and despair, the prophet Zechariah paints a picture of a king to come who's both triumphant and humble. One who comes riding a donkey, a colt, a foal, anything but a war horse. Zechariah conjures a prince of peace. Then he calls the people prisoners of hope. Return to your stronghold, O prisoners of hope, urging them to look beyond the present to possibilities, to look for justice, to work for justice in the midst of an unjust occupation, to expect the one who comes in the name of the Lord. You can see how people in Jesus' time and throughout the ages would also be inspired by these words of Zechariah, how Christians might associate Zechariah's prophecy with Jesus entering Jerusalem on the day we call Palm Sunday. I would contend that we too are called to be prisoners of hope. People who, despite plenty of reasons for despair, can't help but hope. Yes, our lives have been largely displaced by the pandemic. Yes, we are depleted by what we have been through. Yes, our nation has profound, unresolved racial and economic injustice. We've been struggling to keep our democracy, and we have much work to do to make it right. Yes, we all carry our own burdens. And yet, we can't quite escape from the Christian hope, the promise of newness and fullness of life as we await the coming of Christ in glory and the completion of God's purpose for the world. Because even on those days, when I lose hope, I know you're there to hope for me. And on those days when you're beyond hope, we're here for you too. So we can't help but stick with hope. Despite the odds, we're prisoners of hope. Hope in God's word made flesh, Jesus. We're prisoners of hope. Just being here today, after 2 years of not being able to have a full-fledged Palm to Passion Sunday, we're out of practice, out of step. And yet, here we are, taking even baby steps together as prisoners of hope. We're prisoners of hope. When we're concerned, of course, about rising prices, not just for ourselves, but especially for the most vulnerable. So we dig a little deeper and give a little more, as many did in the rain yesterday at the drive-thru. We're prisoners of hope when we don't just fret about people in trouble, be it the sick child down the street or civilians halfway across the world in Ukraine. But we pray for them. We commend them to the care of God who is our hope. We're prisoners of hope when we shout, Hosanna, one moment, knowing full well that we'll soon shout, Crucify him. All the while trusting that there is an A word in our future next week. We can't help but be prisoners of hope as we approach Good Friday, professing that Jesus endured the worst that this world can visit, the worst that has been done to us, and that we ourselves have done, and yet redeemed it all in love. We're prisoners of hope whenever we say, I'm sorry. Whenever we say, I love you. And whenever we show up wherever we need it, even though we don't know what to say. We're prisoners of hope, frankly, when we sincerely pray the powerful Palm to Passion prayer we'll offer in a moment, when we hope against hope that the parts of our lives that are dying and dead can be made new. We're prisoners of hope, locked tight, safe and secure, and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is the key. This week, this holy week, return to Jesus, your stronghold. Oh, prisoners of hope.
We're the church. St. Peter's Monroe, St. Mark's Mystic, St. Michael's Naugatuck, St. Mark's New Britain. For hospital chaplains, Stephen ministers, pastoral care groups, ministries of healing, nurses, wellness programs, recovery ministries, and for the people of St. Paul's, particularly for those experiencing and supporting others in recovery. For the world, nation, and community. For an end to the war in Ukraine and the protection of the civilian population. And for other concerns mentioned now silently or aloud. In thanksgiving, for the many parish volunteers whose faithful efforts help us observe a meaningful Holy Week. And for other thanks offered now silently or aloud. For those in any need or trouble, mentioning by name today, Haley, Jean, Patrick, Beverly, Christopher, Stephen, Alan, Lee, and others named silently or aloud. For the departed, for Mary Beth Cameron Sinceri, for Christopher White, and for others named now silently or aloud. Returning to page 4 in the bulletin, prayers for Palm to Passion Sunday. Jesus, our Savior, you entered Jerusalem with honor and glory. Help us to give glory and honor to you in all that we do and all that we say.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of God.
Jesus, our Savior, you entered Jerusalem in humility, riding on a donkey. Grant us humility in our achievements, and help us to give thanks for our failures and disappointments, remembering always our dependence on you for all that we have and all that we are.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of God.
Jesus, our Savior, many joined in the parade and then turned against you. We pray for our enemies, for those from whom we are estranged, and those from whom we have separated ourselves.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of God.
Jesus, our Savior, you emptied yourself, taking the form of a slave. We pray for all who are oppressed by injustice and poverty. We ask your forgiveness for the ways we contribute to injustice and poverty, and ask you to turn our hearts and minds to lives of simplicity and service.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of God.
Jesus, our Savior, you were crucified by the religious and the righteous. We pray for your church, that we may be ever mindful that in you there are no outcasts.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of God.
Jesus, our Savior, you suffered betrayal, torture, agony, and death. We pray for all those who suffer physically, mentally, and spiritually. We pray that they may know your comfort and presence, especially when they feel abandoned and alone.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of God.
Jesus, our Savior, we know that you rose again and bring new life to all. We pray for those who have died and for the parts of our lives that are dead to you. Bring us new life and help us bring new life to others.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of God. Amen. The peace of our Lord be always with you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O gracious God, we thank you so much for Gene and for his family whom you have given us to love. We pray that in the year ahead, he may continue to go from strength to strength in your love and service. And for this, we hope we can be his faithful companions along the way, supporting and loving him. In your name, O one who comes in the name of the Lord, we pray. Amen. He's very faithful, a member of our online congregation with people in different states. We know that across people across town. And we have a couple international friends. Our friend in Poland, Prosnet, sadly has just shared that he was diagnosed this week with MS. So we will add him to our prayer list and carry him in our prayers. And that is a life's milestone of a different type, is it not? So we pray for him. Plenty of announcements to keep you busy. Reading today on pages 11 through 14 of your bulletin, and page 14 in particular is the Holy Week through Eastertide schedule that I want you to pay particular attention to this day. Thank you. Karen Rowe of our Altar Guild.
Good morning. Before you all walk out, if you wouldn't mind brightening someone's day with a flower. We have the packages over here, and we have the cards up at the front here. You can get somebody that's close to you, or, you know, and they would love that. And also, help yourselves to more palm crosses and long palm to either give to friends or keep for yourself. We'd love for you to take them home.
For yourself and for them. Thank you, Karen. Our Altar Guild works very hard to make these gifts available. Thank you. And that is our Monday, Thursday night watch prayer vigil. That is after that liturgy, after the stripping of the altar. We're here answering Jesus's question. Can you not stay awake 1 hour with me? And so we answer that by offering our all-night night watch prayer vigil, asking folks to give an hour or two to come in and offer prayers for an hour. There is a sign-up sheet. Actually, you got it. You may have gotten an email this morning, and on this bulletin, you can click online and register, as many people have. Or I printed out the sheet. It is on the old-fashioned way, on the easel in the back, if you would like to take an hour or so of that. I want you to know that there was someone who was very faithfully assigned to be in the church all night. You will never be walking into an empty building. So you can feel comfortable to come here and to offer prayers for an hour or so in the wee hours. And I thank you in advance for partaking of that, probably what will be a very powerful experience for you. So thank you. I beseech you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present yourselves as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship.
Thank you.
these gifts so generously given, for those sent in and given online, we say, all things come of thee, O Lord, and of thine own have we given thee. Amen. Follow Eucharistic Prayer A, beginning on page 5 of your worship leaflet. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. For our sins he was lifted high up on the cross, that he might draw the whole world to himself, and by his suffering and death, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who put their trust in him. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension. We offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God. In the bottom half of page 8, together, let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. I invite the congregation to become or to remain seated as the readers for the Passion please come forward.
2 days before Passover, the chief priests and scribes were plotting how they could arrest Jesus and have him killed without upsetting the people. Jesus was staying in the town of Bethany at the house of Simon the leper. As he was sitting at the dinner table, a woman came in with a beautiful jar of expensive ointment. She opened the jar and poured the ointment on his head. Some in the room saw this and said, "Why the waste?
Why would you spend so much on this when money could have been given instead to the poor, hungry, and homeless?"
Jesus told them to leave her alone, for she was doing everything she could to honor him and get ready for what was to come.
I tell you, wherever the good news is proclaimed in the whole world, what she has done will be told in memory of her.
Judas Iscariot, one of Jesus' 12 disciples, told Jesus' enemies where they could find and arrest him. They promised Judas 30 pieces of silver if he would deliver Jesus to them. As they were eating their Passover dinner, Jesus said,
"One of you is going to betray me and hand me over to my enemies."
The disciples were stunned with grief.
"Surely not I."
"Nor I."
Judas slipped out into the night. As they were eating, Jesus took bread, blessed it, broke it into pieces, and gave it to them, saying, Then he picked up a cup of wine, thanked God, and said,
"This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for many. I tell you that I shall not share wine with you again until the kingdom of heaven."
After dinner, they sang songs and went to the Mount of Olives. As they walked, Jesus said to his disciples,
"You will desert me this very night."
"Even if everyone else leaves you, I will never leave you."
"I tell you truly that this very night, before the rooster crows twice, you shall deny me 3 times.
"Even if I must die with you, I will never deny you."
And all the disciples said the same. They went to the garden called Gethsemane. Jesus told them to pray, sit and pray while he went ahead alone. There he prayed.
"It's up to you, Father, for all things are possible. Yet not what I want, but what you want. I will do what you want."
Then Jesus returned and found them sleeping.
"Peter, could you not stay awake even 1 hour?"
Again, Jesus went away apart to pray. When he returned, he found the disciples sleepy again. He went back to pray a third time. After that, he woke up the disciples and told them,
"The hour is come. See, my betrayer is at hand."
Just then, Judas showed up with an army of men with swords and clubs. Judas told him that the man he kissed would be Jesus.
"Rabbi."
Then he gave Jesus a kiss. The soldiers arrested Jesus. One of the disciples took out his sword and cut off the ear of one of the slaves. Jesus said to the soldiers,
"Have you come with swords and clubs to arrest me as if I were a bandit? I've been teaching in the temple every day. Why didn't you come and get me there? But this is the way the scriptures said it would be."
Right then, the disciples ran away, leaving Jesus alone. The The soldiers took Jesus to the high priest, where all the authorities were gathered. Peter followed at a distance, right into the courtyard of the high priest. He sat down next to a fire to warm himself. Now the chief priests and the whole council tried to find testimony against Jesus so they could put him to death, but they couldn't find any. Some people stood up to talk about Jesus, but their stories didn't match, so their testimony was thrown out. Caiaphas, the high priest, asked Jesus,
"Don't you have anything to say about these stories we hear about you?"
Jesus said nothing. Again, Caiaphas asked,
"Are you the Messiah, the Son of the Blessed One?"
"I am, and you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power, coming with the clouds of heaven."
"That's all I need to hear. He has condemned himself."
All of them said Jesus deserved to die. Some began to spit on him, blindfold him, and strike him, saying,
"Tell us more, prophet of God.
Prophesy, who is striking you?"
Meanwhile, a servant girl saw Peter in the courtyard.
"You were with Jesus, weren't you?"
"I don't know what you're talking about."
Just then, Peter heard the rooster crow. The servant girl told people,
"This is one of them."
Again, Peter said he was not, but others said to him,
"You are from Galilee, just like the rest of them."
"I don't know this man, Jesus, you're talking about."
The rooster crowed a second time, just like Jesus said it would. Peter broke down and cried. In the morning, the chief priests and the rest of them had a meeting. They tied Jesus' hands together, led him away, and took him to Pilate, a Roman governor. Pilate asked him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
"You say so."
The chief priests started listing all their charges against him. Pilate said,
"What do you have to say for yourself?"
Pilate was amazed that Jesus did not reply. It was a tradition to release a prisoner during the Passover festival. The people could choose who they wanted to be released. The chief priests talked the people into asking for a man named Barabbas, who was in prison with the rebels who had committed murder. So they chose Barabbas instead of Jesus. Pilate asked what they wanted him to do with Jesus. The crowd shouted,
"Crucify him! Crucify him!"
What evil has he done?
Crucify him! Crucify him!
Pilate wanted to keep the crowd happy, so he released Barabbas. He had Jesus whipped and sent him to be nailed on a cross. The soldiers made fun of Jesus. They put a purple robe on him and a fake crown. They spit on him. When they were done mocking him, they put his own clothes back on and took him to be crucified. Jesus was too weak to carry his cross, so they found Simon of Cyrene in the crowd and got him to carry the cross. They brought him to a place called Golgotha, which means the skull. They offered Jesus some wine to ease his pain, but he refused it. They nailed him to the cross and divided his clothes, casting lots for them. It was 9 in the morning. A sign was hung over his head saying, "The King of the Jews." Two bandits were crucified right next to him. People walked by and shouted to Jesus,
"Save yourself if you're the Son of God."
The chief priests mocked him too, saying,
"Cannot save himself."
Even those on the crosses next to him made fun of him. At noon, the whole world went dark until 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Jesus called out to God, which means,
"My God, why have you forsaken me? Where are you, God?"
Someone got a sponge of sour wine for him. Then Jesus cried out one last time and took his last breath. Suddenly the curtain of the temple was torn in two. When Mary Magdalene and many other women who supported Jesus were there watching from a distance, a centurion, a Roman soldier, who was at the foot of the cross and had seen and heard all of this, said,
"Truly, this man was God's son."
Bow down before the Lord. Almighty God, we pray you graciously behold this your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed and given into the hands of sinners and to suffer death upon the cross, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. Thank you, God, for leading us through this holy liturgy, and now send us forth, continuing to serve you in the liturgy of the world. You so love. In your love we pray. Amen.